where we are today.
Even after a public meeting Thursday night, officials connected to the reevaluation study of Francis E. Walter Dam say there's misconceptions. So Eyewitness News sought out a third-party federal organization to dispel any rumors like Lehigh River water possibly going to New York City.
We're totally unaware of any plan and would think it would be super impractical and unpopular to do literally across basin diversion of any additional waters.
The United States Geological Survey's Northeast and Appalachian region contains the entirety of the Delaware River Basin, and they have spent years working with the three organizations involved with the study.
I think this is more into the wiring of the system and how upstate reservoirs could be operated to meet downriver objectives. Not literally to have water moved around a crossing basin.
The legal history behind the states and organizations around the basin keeps them constantly re-evaluating and planning together.
We get together regularly, I would say monthly, with the other basin states to plan for the future.
New York City's reservoirs may extend more than 100 miles past city limits already, but a large amount of the water that benefits the entire basin flow comes from them, and that explains the city having so much skin in the game.
And to do those sorts of things, we actually are releasing drinking water downstream, right? So in the early 90s, the folks who operated the system, I mean, they would think that this is absolutely nuts. But with the technology we have now to monitor the inflow and understand how much water is coming into the system and how much is able to be released, we're able to do things now that we couldn't have done back then. And it really allows us to manage those reservoirs for multiple objectives and multiple stakeholders, rather than just saying this is for the water supply and nothing else.
The Delaware River Basin Commission was formed in a time of drought, but they have since played a guiding role for organizations within the basin to keep the more than 15,000 square miles of waterways running smoothly.
Right, so we think that there are ways to operate the reservoir to still make releases for fisheries, to still have the same recreational releases, but we could get some benefits for drought storage, for dry weather flow, and it's really, there are a lot of opportunities here, and why not? Let's take a look. I mean, we're taking a look. We're not making a decision.
The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is the prime financial contributor and is running the study.
We're really looking for win-win potential solutions for all stakeholders. There'll be a number of different alternatives and recommendations that we'll look at over the course of the study, but we are just getting started at this point.
All three organizations are looking for potential solutions and improvements for the entire basin.
One thing we've said from the beginning is this has to be an honest study that's based on science. If the science shows it can't be done, it can't be done. That's fine. If the science shows it can, then everyone should get together and figure out if that's something we want to pursue.
The USGS works regularly with these organizations on data collection and various studies.
Since day one, we have worked with the New York DEP, with the Corps of Engineers, with the DRBC, and they have always been absolutely straight shooters.
There are certainly concerns the region has, as one of their lifebloods is directly under the microscope. But a full Mountain Laurel conference room this past week is applauded by stakeholders and onlookers alike.
Those are public processes, and the public is invited and has the right to go look at the information as it's being developed. You know, the public gets an input into the study itself.
The USGS adds that this team effort over the past 50-plus years puts the region and this study in better hands than most.
In some places like Georgia, there's big challenges with water rights and water availability associated with the core reservoirs. And there's parts of the country and a lot of the globe where there really, literally isn't enough water. And so it's very litigious. There are winners and losers, but there's plenty of room for science and information in the East to really kind of retain this balancing act in the East, where we should be able to do, the most good with the resources.
The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers will take written comment and suggestions on their website throughout this process, but encourage early submissions for the first phase of public input by the end of January. Kevin Hayes, Eyewitness News.